and welcome to my channel. Today I have a video for you that I sort of realized I should have done before Halloween. Namely, how to get very long hair underneath a wig. But yeah, I figured, you know, there's probably people who do cosplay or special effects makeup, special looks, photo shoots, stuff like that, that who want to wear a wig because, you know, coloring your hair every 3 weeks would probably not be very healthy for your hair. But struggle with getting all their hair underneath a wig cap. And yeah, I gotta admit I struggled with it as well. That's why actually I'm making this video. I looked up a lot of tutorials, but what bothered me was that a lot of them were pretty complicated. And me, I'm lazy. I'm very lazy. I'm extremely lazy. So I wanted a method that worked, but was still easy and quick to do. Because after all, it doesn't need to look fancy. Like, it's gonna be hidden. That's the entire point. And yeah, I just wanted something easy. So I figured out a way to do it without needing to spend 12 hours on it first. All you need for this is obviously a wig and a wig cap. You'll also need a comb is sort of useful. And these little bobby pins, just basic bobby pins. I try to go for the non-colored ones. But yeah, anyway, it doesn't really matter because it will be hidden anyway. Also, one of these things. I have no idea what these are called. They're just those clicky thingies. And also an elastic band, a hair band, whatever. I'm using one of those very, very tiny little ones just because they're easier to hide and you don't have a big piece of elastic just sitting there. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna turn around and obviously you're going to see the tutorial from the back of my head because otherwise you wouldn't be able to see what I'm doing. Yeah, other than that, I really hope the camera will be focused on me. I won't be able to tell, obviously. Anyway, I hope it will remain focused, but we shall see. Just turning around real quick, because the microphone also isn't made to be listening to the back of someone's head. I'm going to do a French braid first, because this is a nice stable base for this sort of thing. Not the neatest French braid I've ever made, I know, but it doesn't matter because we're going to cover it with a wig anyways. But yeah, the French braid is just going to make sure that the clicky black thingy has something to really grab onto and stick in place. And also, obviously, one braid is much easier to handle than, you know, thousands, millions, I don't know how many hairs an average human has. But, you know, like, it's easier to handle than loose hair. Also, I almost forgot, one other thing you'll need for the wig cap specifically are these sort of hair clips. I also don't know how these are called. I always call them the clicky hair clips because they click, but now what I'm gonna do is stick this thing in my hair and also use the bobby pins to pin my braid around it. Again, it doesn't need to be neat. What it does need to be is flat. That's the entire point of this all. It needs to be flat. Okay, so we're at this point now. Yeah, this is just, well, actually this is quite still a nice hairdo, I think. I do sometimes actually wear it like this, but anyway, what the flat clip, like the big black clip does, it just gives extra strength as well, and also it gives you something to wrap your hair around so you can make it flatter. But also because the bobby pins slide underneath it, they're extra stuck in there, so they really hopefully won't budge. And yeah, then we're going to move on to the wig cap. This is actually just the whole regular putting a wig on thing, but you know, just to be complete, I'll just show it to you as well. Always like to start at the back and then work to the front. My BB cream today is not smudge proof. And then, of course, time for the wig. I'm using my only wig. This is a white cosplay wig that I got off eBay. It's very obviously fake. It sheds a little. It is nicely heavy, though. And it has this weird thing where all the hair comes from one single spot. Anyway, yeah, it works for the looks where my own orange hair just isn't gonna work. Like an ice demon, for example, with orange hair is just sort of odd. To me, at least. I mean, I want everything cool toned then. But anyway, point is, yeah. Also, I gotta admit, I never do anything with these little straps here because I don't quite get how they're supposed to work. If anyone does know, enlighten me in the comment section. But yeah, if you're better at actually putting on a wig than I am, then you'll probably know more about it. But yeah, I'm just gonna put it on my way. Starting at the front and I'm pulling it to the back. Without the bangs, these would probably be easier to wear. So then we're left with this. The wig is on. Yeah, I do actually like how this wig looks once I actually styled a little. As you can tell, you have a bit of a bigger head than normal when you're wearing a wig like this, but it is smooth. You don't get a weird bump from a bun underneath the wig. And you also don't get this awkward effect where your own hair is longer than the wig and the braid is like dropping out from underneath it, which I also used to do sometimes. Yeah, it just works. So yeah, I really hope this tutorial was useful to some of you, or that it was at least fun to watch. If you did enjoy it, please click the like button, it would really help me out. And if you want to, you can also subscribe to my channel. I do mostly makeup tutorials, actually. And yeah, below this video, you can find a full list of all my social media accounts and names. I'm mostly active on Instagram with a lot of makeup. And I'd really love it if you don't follow me there. And that was it for today. Thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you'll have a wonderful day, and I hope to see you next time. Bye.